Now, after understanding the concept of the force exerted by the fluid onto a bend, let's have a look at a question on that concept. The question says we have a diffuser pipe which is flowing, which is having a shape of this sort. Now, at section 1, the dia is 600 mm, which means it is 0.6 meters. And at the section 2, you have dia is 300 mm. Which means 0.3 meters. Now the pressure at the bend, which is equal to P1, is 8.829 newtons per centimeter square. Convert that into pascals by multiplying this by 10 to the power 4. And then you have Q, which is 600 LPS or 0.6 meter cube per second. So let's first of all find out A1 and A2. So A1 would be pi by 4 into 0.6 square. This would be 0.2827 meter square. Then we have A2. A2 will be equal to pi by 4 into 0.3 square, which is 0.07068 meter square. Alright, so we have these values. Now we don't know what is the velocity at these two ends. Because we have Q and we have the two areas, we can apply the continuity equation on this. So you will have V1 as Q upon A1 and V2 as Q upon A2. Alright, so you have Q which is 0.6. upon 0.2827, this would be equal to 2.122 meters per second, and then V2 would be 0.6 upon, this would be 0.07068, this would be equal to 8.488 meters per second. So we have the velocities at section 1 and at section 2. Okay, now we have P1, we also need P2 to find out Fx and to find out Fy. Right, let's use the Bernoulli's equation and find out P2. So, if you apply the Bernoulli's equation, you will get P2 upon rho g plus Z2 plus V2 square upon 2g is equal to P1 upon rho g plus Z1 plus V1 square upon 2g. So from here I can strike off the elevations. Let us assume the bend is not so high, it is almost at the same level. So I have all the values. I have P1, I have V1, I have V2. Let's assume that you have water flowing in this. So the density would be 1000. Okay, so let me find out the value for P2 by rho g. So it will be equal to P1, which is 8.829, now it becomes Pascal. Then you have rho g, which is 9810 plus V1 square. V1 is 2.122 square. Okay, and then you have V2, so I'll subtract it, which is 8.488 square, divided by 2 into 9.81. So when you do your calculation, the pressure head at section 2, which is P2 by rho g, it would come out to be, it would be equal to 5.5575 meters of water. Alright, so from now this head is given to us, we can find out the pressure P2. So P2 would be 5.5575 into 9810, and this would be in Pascals. Okay, so the value would be equal to 5.45 into 10 to the power 4 Pascals. So that is P2. Okay, so I hope this is clear. So now we have P2, we have V2, we have V1, we have P1. And this is all that we require to find out Fx and Fy. So if you remember the equation for fx, it was p1a1 minus p2a2, okay, and it was plus rho q into v1 minus v1, that is v2 into cos theta. That is what we have, okay. And then the value for fy would be equal to, it would be equal to minus p2 a2 sin theta, okay. This would also be p2 a2 cos theta. You will have cos theta over here, plus minus p2 a2 sin theta minus rho q into v2 sin theta. So this is the value that you are going to get. Okay. Now, there is a major issue in this. You don't know the value of cos theta, you don't know the value of sin theta, because the value of theta is unknown. So what we are going to do, we are going to divide these two equations. From here, we will find out the value for theta. So you can take cos theta common, and then you can take the value of sin theta common and divide them, you will get tan theta. So from here, the value of theta will come out to be 17 degrees 36 minutes. Now based upon that input, you can find out fx and fy. So fx, so now you can put theta into this equation for fx. So now fx would be equal to 1,99,11.4 newtons, and fy would be equal to minus 6,322.4 newtons. Now with y being negative, this means this supposition that your fy is acting in the vertically upward direction is incorrect. This means it is acting in the vertically downward direction, and your fr would be somewhere over here. Alright, so fr, if you find out the square root of these two added, and you will get fr from there. So you will have fr is equal to under root fx square plus fy square. So you can put in these two numerical values, square them up and take the under root, and that value will be 20,890.9 newtons. So that is how you attempt a question like this. Look at the data given to you, find out the requisite data, and simply apply these two equations. Okay. So I hope you got this. Now let's look at one more example on this before moving forward.